Hello, I am Jack Sifri, a MIMIC design flow specialist at Keysight Technologies. In this short video, I want to show you how to set up and EM simulate RF modules that comprise different technologies. This will help you predict package, board, and bondwire effects on your RF module prior going to fabrication. I will also show you how to download the project files along with a workshop document to help you get started and practice the process shown on this video. First, allow me to illustrate the objectives with an example. Here I have a two-stage LTE MIMIC power amplifier. And next to it are the circuit simulation results, which is shown in black, and the EM simulation results, which is shown in red, of the amplifier gain. Next, I inserted this MIMIC chip into a QFM package and I bondwired its RF and DC pads as shown here. Now look at the EM simulation results on the whole module, shown in blue. The results clearly show how the overall gain got reduced and drooped furthermore at the higher frequencies. It's all due to the effects of the package, bond wires, and mismatch losses. Before I jump into the tutorial part, let me show you an internal Keysight design that demonstrates some of the final results of the process I'm going to show you. This LNA was designed by my colleague Matt Ozalas, and it was fabricated and measured at our Keysight Technology Center. The module FEM simulation is shown in blue and the measurements are shown in red. The results agree and are well within the window of process variation, and all the effects of the package and bond wires are included. So now, in this video tutorial, I'm going to use an integrated passive device, which is a 7 to 9 GHz X-band filter. I'm going to use it as the IC. And I'm going to show you how to insert it into a package and mount it onto a laminate board with bond wires and solder paste. At the end, I will perform FEM simulation on the whole module and predict the effect of the package and bond wires on the filter response prior to fabrication. So here's a preview of our tutorial. First, we start with this MIMIC filter that has its micron layout units and its own material and layer stackup. Then we add to it this QFN package and laminate board with millimeter layout units and its own material and layers stackup. We then combine these technologies together into one module and perform FEM simulation on it. The first step is we start a new workspace and we call it module. And we want to populate this module workspace with the filter and the QFM package and laminate. So the way to do this, we go to manage libraries and notice here I added add library definition file. So when I click on this, I can browse and find the location of the QFM package and the X-band filter, and I bring them. When I add this, I bring these libraries into my workspace. So when I do this and I close this, I notice my filter and the QFN package are imported into this new module workspace. Then I open a new layout called Assembly. I call this layout Assembly. You just click on this layout for a new layout window, and I called it Assembly. And then all I have to do is drag and drop. Here's the package. And then I do the same thing to the filter. Here's I drag and drop the filter. And this is what I did, you know, when I built this module. This is how I started. Okay? The only thing I want to point out to you is I need to nest this IC onto this whole structure. So the way I did this is I went to Options, Technology, Nested Technology, and I added a new nested technology. I called it filter. And I open this nested technology and notice I need the IC to be pointing up on top of the package surface. So I selected this. If I want a flip chip, I would select this one for flip chip. But this is the way I wanted it. This is how you set up the nested technology between the IC and the laminate and the package. So the next step is to add the bond wires. And the way I did this, I say insert bond wire. Here, let me move this. And I click from the IC to the upper pad. That's how I added the bond wire. So you can see I just added another bond wire here. And I did the same thing at the output. I started from the IC and I landed on the upper pad of the package. Next, we have to add the ports. And the ports consist for FEM simulations of two pins, the signal pin and the reference ground pin. So notice the signal pins are P1 and P2. Input and output, and the reference ground for each one is, it's shown in green, it's hard to see, it's green, it's P3 and P4. So the way I added these pins, the signal and the ground pins, is I click on this insert pin. It gives me a pin that I can insert it at any location and I want, and I can select the layer that it lands on. So you can see here I have four pins, two at the input, two at the output, which is signal ground, signal ground. And finally, in order to do FEM simulation on the whole module, I must have a substrate stack up for the whole module. So the way I did this, here, let me open first the substrate for this module. The way I did this, I started with the existing substrate of the package, the QFM package, which already comes with the design, with the package design. Then what I did is I right click on this surface here, on the top surface, and I insert nested substrate. So by clicking this, notice it inserts a nested substrate. I already did this for the filter here by inserting it, and then you can fill in the boxes on the right side. Use a nested technology, which is the filter nested technology, and what is the substrate of the filter, and I did say filter substrate. Now you have a whole module substrate, and if I double click on this substrate for the filter, it opens up the actual mimic filter substrate. Then I can save it. This is my substrate. Save it as the assembly substrate. And this is how I built this, the module substrate. So now I am ready to run the FEM simulation on the whole module. To do this, I click on the EM simulation setup icon here. And notice I selected FEM simulation. This is the substrate, the assembly substrate we built for the whole module. These are the ports, frequency plan, everything is ready, and all I have to do now is click on simulate to start the FEM simulation. And this launches the FEM simulation on the whole module. After it is done, all the data is saved automatically in the workspace, and we can plot and see the FEM results on the module. This is the whole 3D structure of the module, the IC, the package, and the laminate. Okay, so here are the simulation results. First, I'm showing here the initial design results using circuit models. Next, shown in red, are the FEM results on the filter by itself. And finally, here is the whole module FEM results displayed in blue. It shows a drastic shift in frequency and more loss due to the package and bond wire effects. I also want to point out that this nested technology concept is very flexible and can be widely used on larger modules and even transceivers. For example, here is a PA switch module that comprises of a laminate board with three ICs, two PAs and a switch, all sitting on top of a PCB test board along with 3D connectors and solder bumps components. The assembly process is no different than what I have shown on this video. Here are the ICs nested on the laminate board to make up the module. And then this whole module is nested again onto the PCB board as shown here. Also, you can have different IC process technologies. For example, the PA could be implemented on GaAs process and the switch on SiGe, silicon germanium process. You can also include CMOS process designs with hundreds of layers. This whole nested technology concept is very flexible and versatile. I hope you have found this tutorial useful. You see, performing FEM simulation on your RF module prior to fabrication is important. It predicts the effects of the package and bond wires, and it allows you to fix problems in the design prior to fabrication. You can get the project files and a useful workshop document to get you started on this nested technology process by clicking on the link in the text description at the right side, or you can click on the following URL. Thank you for watching.